Esports isn't just a fad. It's a massive cultural phenomenon, set to take over the world with a new generation of athletes battling in virtual worlds created using advanced computing technology.
And it takes a supercomputer to really make this lifelike game environment exist. The textures, the hair, the effect of wind, how water moves, all of these things are being physically modeled at a speed that feels very real. And they're doing that with technology, and they're doing that in cooperation with us at Hewlett Packard Enterprise. My earliest programming experiences were literally solving tic-tac-toe style games on personal computers back in the 80s. Now, I'm building some of the world's most powerful supercomputers to take on some of the world's most grand scientific problems in a computational way. Supercomputers are used in all kinds of applications today based on this very simple idea of modeling and simulation. When we don't understand something physically, it helps us to build a model of it. And we do that in software now. First, we develop the physical characteristics of the object, and then we act on it with forces to simulate real-world phenomena. So you can think of pushing on the object, and does it compress, does it crush, how does it move, how fast, how does it interact with its surroundings. We use them to forecast the weather. We use them to predict where the stock market is going. We use them to design cars and airplanes. I don't think folks understand that behind all that is supercomputing. Gaming technology relies heavily on graphical processing, or GPUs, instead of CPUs. GPUs use a divide and conquer approach to data. We use those same GPUs now in supercomputing to solve mathematical equations. Fundamentally, what this will allow us to do is build larger, more powerful supercomputers. An individual chip today can perform a trillion mathematical equations per second. A trillion. There's no end to the capabilities of the human race to make advances through mathematical simulations. That's what excites me, to be able to see the advancements that 12-year-old kid couldn't have imagined. But today, anything's possible.